Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I'm going to speak about the commonly faced problem by each and every student of homeopathy as well as each and every homeopathic practitioner, that is criticism. So this is a very, you know, often not spoken thing in the college mostly, but I guess it is the first thing one has to come in contact, understand once one enter medical college, especially homeopathic medical college, because homeopathy is a verge of science. Like, it is not actually understood by everyone as a science, so it is a bit hard to get approval from the people directly, where allopathy is understood and welcomed very easily, whereas homeopathy is not done when compared to that of allopathy. And unfortunately, the very bad thing that is happening is most of the people who themselves are in the study of homeopathy, they themselves criticize homeopathy, but I wouldn't say wrong about them as well, because the science, I would say, is not developed to such an extent where there can be some provision of proof regarding homeopathy. And the main drawback I believe homeopathy has is vastness of the symptoms, or is its vastness of the literature. It's very hard to refer many of the books in the homeopathy, and it's very easy to get wander off. So coming back to the exact point of the video, criticism. So actually we have to wear a helmet and we have to armor ourselves and be ready to face the criticism. And most of the times we are not made ready by the college, but the thing is, I believe being able to face criticism is the greatest quality each and every homeopathy person should be inculcating. And it's very common, as I already said, as it is not up to the mark when compared to that of the allopathy. It's not being accepted as a science as much as allopathy is accepted. So the thing is, what I believe is, the criticism, keeping criticism aside, there is also a bit of mistake of the homeopathy practitioners, including me. But the thing is, we don't learn from our mistakes very easily. We most of the time blame allopath practitioners that they are just bringing us down. But I believe if we have the similar concentration in understanding our literature in a better way, I guess we will be having a very good, we will be very successful in getting some good results from the patients. And even in the beginning of my graduation as well, I was very much concerned about what people will be thinking about me when I start practicing. And I was very much insecure about my practice, to be frank. I wasn't never a confident person from the beginning, especially when you enter homeopathy by chance and not by choice as such. I was a person who got into homeopathy by chance, not by choice. So, but at this given moment of time, I've gained maturity enough that homeopathy is not, the society is not used to the way of practice of homeopathy, because one reason is there are the number of people who want quick fixes is increasing day by day, and homeopathy is lacking, especially in the treatment of acute cases, because we are very much frightened to handle them. But trust me, it's not the true scenario. As you know, if you have watched my previous video, I dealt with my own chikungunya fever under the guidance of my guru. I just stick to the homeopathy medicines, and I didn't take in any allopathy medication. I was cured very well, and I'm perfectly all right. And that was a very acute situation. It was the fever was around 104, so still I was able to cope up with that. So I guess that is what we are in need of, it that at this given moment of time, a little bit of belief in our own system, which is only possible if we understand the basics well. But before even understanding the basics, we have to have a blind belief and faith in homeopathy. That is only found in a very less group of people, and I guess those are the people who just go forward and make the system proud. And I'm really grateful that I met such wonderful people in form of my guru especially. I'm really really glad, and I would take this moment of Teacher's Day of thanking my guru for actually making me understand what homeopathy is, how great system that is. And my whole and soul aim in starting this channel is actually, in the beginning I was thinking of sharing about Materia Medicas, but the thing is this Materia Medicas are all over thought, and I guess every homeopathy student is actually well versed with the remedies, but the thing is it is the ideas or the idea or the thought behind that practice is need to be changed, and the commitment and the drive to practice homeopathy and not to give up on homeopathy is something which needs to be inculcated and specially taught in the colleges, which is not gonna happen any soon. But being a person who have seen the greatness of homeopathy, it's my responsibility that I share with you all what I actually feel and what I learned in my process of practicing homeopathy, though it's been 1.5 or 2 years I've been in this practice. But I'm lucky enough that I've witnessed some great cases and some great cures in homeopathy. And so I would like to wind up by saying, if you find any criticism against homeopathy, step back and just analyze the situation. Don't get into reactive mode. Try to respond to the situation rather than react and make a fuss out of that. And give homeopathy some time. Just give us some time. There will be a point of time where actually scientific evidence can be provided in front of the society what actually homeopathy is. Before that, let us all concentrate in having a better knowledge of the subject and making ourselves potent enough to meet the health issues that the present society is facing, so that we can help these human beings, our co-fellow human beings who are suffering, in a best way, in the best way we can. So that's all I want to say. So yeah, this brings me to the end of this video. Don't react to the criticism if you ever face. Try to respond to that and try to learn from each failure you face. And trust me, each and every case failed once, if you have a perfect understanding of what actually failed you in that given situation, it won't be repeated again. And that's where we have to brace up ourselves and improve ourselves. So yeah, that's all for this video. Thanks a lot for listening to this. Sorry, I was in a podcast mode. Thanks a lot for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for such videos regarding the subject, as well as the mindset you have to inculcate, so that you can have the better understanding of homeopathy and serve the society in the best way. Bye bye, have a great day.